Welcome to Let's Talk Tailwaggers. It's hard to believe that it's 2018 already, but I know that since I've met these young ladies, we're going to have a wonderful 2018. There's going to be lots of good and wonderful things being done. This show is going to inform you, educate you, let you know, and maybe there's things that you can do to help them, to help the dogs and the kitty cats and everything that they love and take care of. And what is your name?
Hi, I'm Cassie Wilson.
I'm Dina Perry.
And what do you do?
We're volunteer humane officers for All But Furgotten Rescue.
How did you come up with that name? All But Furgotten, oh my God.
It came from the original founders. One of the girls had just...
tore me up.
Yeah, it's a humane rescue and it's not pretty at times.
Wow, and how did you get started?
I started with them fostering a mill mama that needed a place to go.
A mill mama is a poor mama dog that just made babies, right?
Yes.
This one was special. She was surrendered because she was no longer considered a usable dog for them.
Yeah.
And 5 days after getting her into the home, we had three baby girl puppies.
Kill you, huh?
That was our first mill run. And the surviving puppies actually stayed with us in the group. We adopted them within the rescue.
I have one.
Guilty.
Yeah.
What do they call that? Foster
fail. Foster fail. I am.
Aw. So go ahead and just talk and tell me all about everything that you're going to do, like to do.
We were lucky enough to find a kennel that was up for sale. Mm-hmm. We found a wonderful benefactor mm-hmm. to help us.
Wow.
We make payments to her monthly. We could not have afforded it without her.
Wow.
It takes a lot of work. It needed a lot of work. We have had it for almost a year?
A year in December.
Yeah, and it's 75% done.
Uh-huh.
It's a lot of donations are coming in to help us get it done.
Did you hear that, people? Yeah. Lots of donations.
And that's where we started. We were foster based. We still are until the kennels are able mm-hmm. to be up. We do what we can. We plead for fosters. Some are very, very important. They're coming from abusive cases.
Yeah, now the abusive cases. Do you get a lot from Amish places?
Those are our mill dogs.
Those are the heart of our rescue.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because I had someone talk to me about that one time, and I got shivers.
Yeah.
That's one of your most rewarding rescues, taking mm-hmm. them from the horrible situation and... Mm-hmm. bringing them back to being a dog mm-hmm. and everything that they deserve.
And that's the reason that people should not buy puppies from a dog store, because they get them from those horrible places most of the time, not 100%, but most of the time they get them from these places. And the poor little things, the mother has no nourishment to give them because she just had a litter and they took that litter and then she has another litter. Yeah. And that's why they always have illness, because their mother can't give them any immune thing in the nursing milk or anything because she has nothing.
No. Correct.
And they're usually in tiny, dirty confinement.
So
most of them don't know anything about the grass, being in a house, the sunshine.
Oh, God.
Yeah. You know?
Oh, God. Yeah. I can imagine. When this isn't anything like what you do, but I got a kitten and brought it home, and it was walking around the house, and it would go, you know how they make, I call it making bread, you know? They're like this. And he'd do that when he was walking. And I thought, my Lord, there's something wrong with him. He didn't do that where the place, you know, that I had him. So I was out in the kitchen, I guess it was the third day, and I came in and sat down on the floor, and I said, Munchkin, what's wrong with you? I said, how come you walking around like that? And it looks up, and it was like, you never walked on a rug. And he thought it was his mama, I guess.
Aww,
whatever.
Yeah.
And him was just making bread as him was going along,
yeah,
you know.
Oh, good.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. And it's... I had the dogs from North Korea, South Korea. That, I had a gentleman that went and rescued those. And he said those poor creatures, you know.
Our rescue had one.
Yeah, we had one from the meat trade.
Yes. Uh-huh. And her fosters brought her completely around, mm-hmm, to a completely new dog.
Because, mm-hmm, they are intelligent creatures.
Well, in the meat trade, they must keep them in a very small cage.
Right.
So when she came to us, she was hunched all the time. She, aww, was walking like that. She was flat-footed.
Malnutrition.
She was heartworm positive as well.
Yeah.
She was very, very ill. The transformation that her foster mom has done is...
incredible.
Love. It's love.
Yeah, just giving them the time and the patience and they need.
There you go. That's
and that's so important.
Yeah.
So a lot of people think that, you know, you get one of these dogs and it's going to be just like a dog.
Yeah.
A normal dog, and they are.
Well, I don't think even if you get one from a humane society, a nice, you know, humane society or what if you can call them nice, but when you get them, they've all been hurt emotionally, you know, so it's love,
yes,
and patience. That's what it's all about. And if you have love to give, you know, they just suck it right out of you.
Oh yeah, I mean, if you just have a little bit of time and a little bit of room, fostering a dog will be like one of the most rewarding things.
Yeah.
Oh, I would.
I
could imagine. I had quite a few of them years ago. I don't do that any stuff anymore because I'm not well. And if anything happens, I won't have anybody to give them to. Mm-hmm. You know, if I get a dog or the kitty is my son's. But I did all, you know, I was into that so deep.
Yeah.
My girlfriend used to come and say, why don't you charge a quarter for to come in my house?
Quarter a visit, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, because you name it, you know, I'd bring it home. Bring it home. Oh, my, you know. But you guys are blessings. You really are. And you are the Humane Society or Humane.
We're part of the Pennsylvania Humane Society of Westmoreland County.
Okay, yes. Okay. And that's where your new place is going to be?
Our new place is in Swickley Township, which is Westmoreland County.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Well, and are you going to stay there? Are you going to or do you live around this place?
We all do. The board members, I'm the closest. I live about 5 minutes from there, and then we all scatter around.
Yeah.
Very supportive, our little town. They're very supportive of us.
Wow.
It's a lot of work.
It is a lot of work.
You know, but we have a great support system.
Our own families are on back hold, you know, because these animals are first. It's our first priority.
Don't be ashamed of saying that.
Yeah.
It's you know, we're all put on this earth for a reason, you know. And I've had people approach me about doing my show.
Mm-hmm.
You know, why do you do that show for the animals? And, you know, and I just look at them and say, well, why shouldn't I?
Yeah.
I mean, if something you can do, do it.
You know?
That's right. They don't have a voice.
It's true.
That's right.
And, you know, I'm dumbfounded. I've only had that maybe 5 or 6 times in all the years I've been doing my show. Mostly I get people come up and give me a hug and, you know, say thank you. And we didn't know that. They all, one of the things they're famous for is, I didn't know that. I watched your show. I didn't know that. But you just have to understand that what you're doing is good. But you have enough love for your family. Good. You have enough love for everybody.
Yeah.
It's just not... You know,
we're just thankful that our other halves support us.
And then if you have kids and they grow up and they leave, then you'll have something to bury yourself into.
Yeah.
You know, you'll have a kennel.
A lot into this with the humane work. I mean, I don't think it's ever ending.
Yeah.
And we do it after our regular jobs. We go out after our regular jobs.
God bless you.
And this cold spell has really, really kicked us for a loop. Mm-hmm. I mean, we go out after our regular jobs. We don't get in until maybe 10 at night.
Yeah, weekends.
The 32 and under law, you know.
Yeah.
People are just leaving their dogs out. They're surrendering.
And they don't care.
Well, they don't understand.
Surrendering, hooray. You know, hooray that they give them up. But this baloney of tying them outside, I know some men, hunters, believe that beagles should never be inside,
that they should be out in
the cold, because it makes them strong and tough. And I just say to them, well, how about if you put your long underwear on, and I take you out there, and you can sit out and read out there in that overnight, and that should make you strong and tough. That is how stupid that stuff is.
They're not just dogs.
No.
They have feelings.
They do.
You know? They do. They feel.
Well, it's a name, like we're humans. You know, they're dogs. Kitty cats are very intelligent, too, in their own way. Mm-hmm. You know, but dogs were made for us. I don't care if you get mad at me about the Lord or God, but they were made for us. And they were made for us to tell them our secrets to, you know? To just come home from work and be lonely and sad, and they come running down the steps, and how can you be lonely and sad?
You are their whole world.
Yes. Oh.
They wait on you.
Yes.
And that's their purpose.
They know everything.
They do.
About you.
They do.
They keep secrets.
I know. My mom used to say that out in the kitchen. I'd hear her every once in a while saying, if you ever start talking, you're gone.
We would always say, oh my God, if you could only talk.
Yeah, it's true. See the happiness and the joy they bring?
Absolutely.
Yeah. Yeah.
I wouldn't know what to do.
And I bet you it doesn't, when you get one, get them and you bring them, it doesn't take too long to get them unless they've been beaten, abused like those poor fighting dogs. It doesn't take too long to get them to look you in your eye.
Some of the Amish dogs, they really never quite come around.
Oh.
Some of the mamas.
Yeah. Just shy and reserved.
Yeah, we have picked up. They're the ones that we have picked up, and they're the little ones.
Yeah,
They're very ill when we get them.
Sure,
and
so they're
very
they don't grow right.
Yeah, they take a lot out of the rescue. A
lot of vetting.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but they are the most meaningful. You know, they're one of the most meaningful.
Yeah. Well, that goes back to the mamas are so sick that the mamas don't have the nourishment, you know, to nurse them, you know, for their little brains to grow and their little bellies to grow. They do it for money, and I just can never, with all of my heart and my life, can I understand why you do that. Oh, let's have dogs that have 12.
Yeah.
You know, then times 200.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, and I had my own business. I groomed dogs all my life, and I had a very loving and did one dog at a time because I loved them, grooming shop. And so people would say, oh, my brother got the Great Dane, and it's going to have this many puppies and all, you know. And I said, did your brother ever stop and think that maybe you're going to have them cesarean? And there goes, you know, grand or two.
just like the English Bulldogs. I mean, they can't deliver.
Because their heads are too big, right?
I don't think they think it through.
Yeah.
It's
all
about the money.
That's what I'm saying. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Mm-hmm. And thank God there's people like you that at the end of whatever they do, you're there.
We pick up the pieces.
Yeah, and you take care of them and you bring them back and... what would we do without you guys? I'm sincerely, with all my heart, I'm so proud that the Tailwaggers have you on today for my first show of the year. I mean, I truly am. It's marvelous that you two are taking your time out in your life. Now, are you training other people to be in your organization?
We have a lot of volunteers.
Uh-huh.
As far as humane officers go, there are four of us in our rescue.
Wow.
I think that we are holding it pretty well together for being volunteer and doing it.
Yeah.
We're not out there as much as we'd like.
Yeah.
You know, Westmoreland County is a big county. Mm. We do work with other humane officers in the Westmoreland County. I think it's the first time that we all are a unit.
Yeah.
Aww.
Working as
it
a team.
It is wonderful.
Yeah, I bet.
It just brings you a lot of hope.
Yeah.
It really does.
It does. And it respect for each other that mm-hmm. you're doing it, having someone, you know, in a group like that.
Yeah. Well, even together. Local police departments are like jumping in and starting to help.
Oh, they're being
with
wonderful.
The dog laws.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of hope that, you know, it'll get better.
Wow.
I mean, it's never going to be enough in our eyes. It'll never be enough. Mm-hmm. And we're only as good as the law lets us be.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And that's, you know.
Yeah. Yeah.
Sometimes you gotta think what you're allowed to do, not what you want to do.
In your heart,
right?
What you would like to do is take mm-hmm. them out and run them over.
It's very hard to separate.
That.
It's very hard to separate.
Yeah.
Very hard.
Yeah.
It's very frustrating.
Imagine.
We cry a lot.
Yeah, well, see, that's what I mean. God love mm-hmm. your hearts. It just.
Yeah, we cry an awful lot.
Oh, yeah. God.
Somebody has to do it.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Yeah, well.
Here we are.
That's the truth.
Yeah.
Somebody has to do it, and God said for you to do it. I wished I had the strength, really, to do it, but I don't know. You're just special people, and know that. Please know that with all my heart, that I say that with all my heart. You are special, special people.
Thank you. Thank you.
So what else do we want to talk about?
Well, we have different aspects of the rescue. We have
that's it.
Search and rescue, you know, group of us all over, all the counties mm-hmm. work together. Lost dogs, found dogs, trying to get them back home.
We trap them. In fact, we just had one that he was a three-legged dog.
Aww.
He had gotten lost in
Scottsdale,
right from his adopters, within hours.
Gone.
11 months to the day. We had a wonderful man. He led the group, and he trapped him a couple of days ago.
Oh.
Yeah, he's very thin.
Yeah.
Frazier is very thin, and he has pneumonia.
Oh.
But he's going to be.
You think he'll be okay?
They do. They have high hopes.
Yeah.
With the antibiotics.
Yep.
Yeah.
No, those are happy tears.
Those are
happy
tears.
Yeah, those are little
those
stinkers.
Are so happy.
When you get those calls or those messages, everybody's crying.
That's a little stinker.
You know, we finally got him home.
That takes off. You know, people that go to the Humane Society and get a dog, they don't know how long they've been in those cages down there.
Correct.
And they get cage crazy.
Correct.
Yes.
And people don't understand that, and it is not their fault.
Mm-mm.
Okay? And so you bring them home, and they have no idea. They've been in that cage 2 years or 3 years. They're taken out and walked and whatever, but most of the time they're in a cage. And you bring them home, and not all the time, but a few of them, just go nuts.
They
just run around the house. They tear things because they have no idea what I am supposed to do.
Well, we have a good example of that. We have our senior Sheltie that was pulled off of a chain. She lived outside. She was actually pulled from very freezing weather with no straw.
Under zero.
Cassie and Officer Aaron Cassidy went out and they brought her in. And she is in her foster home. She's very ill. She paces because that's all she's used to.
Like a lion.
Yeah.
And she's having a very, very hard time right now. So we are in the process trying to find her another foster who can just give their time to her and let her acclimate to the, you know, she may never, ever.
Maybe if she gets well, those people could start to take her on little walks, like, you know, so, and then bring her back.
She's about 13 or 14.
Oh, well.
So we're not really sure what the future holds for her. So we just need.
She might just be brainwashed. You know, to
that's all she knows.
You know, the anxiety, you know, something new. How long she's been, you know, if she's ever been in the house. So something's new she has to adjust to.
Yeah.
And that's where your time and patience.
Oh, yeah. Yes. And sounds. And noises.
Everything.
It's
all new. And all this newness at the age of 13 or 14.
Well, that's what I mean.
Yeah.
It's pathetic. It's truly pathetic. Yeah. Oh, my God.
I
know the world is not a perfect place, but dogs are truly a gift.
I believe so.
And I wish we could get them to quit with the fighting dogs, you know, mating them. I pray, you know.
That's going to be a hard one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, maybe if we put a person in there instead of a dog with one of them.
Yeah,
I just that just don't
and
they're
puppy mills. I mean, they make bunches of puppies.
Yeah, they do.
You know, and they're and what other organization? What other parts are you going to have?
We have the search and rescue. We have the puppy mills. We do the humane, abused, and neglect.
We also help out like communities, people in need. We help.
Yeah.
Do like some fundraising and stuff to get them and their animals supplies they need.
Yeah.
Oh, how sweet.
Take care of them, you know.
Yeah. Well, there's people that have to give them up when they don't have the money to feed them. That breaks your heart.
Some fall ill and they just need a little
help.
You know, so we like to try to be there for those people. You know, they're there for us, you know, supporting and sharing our posts and being there. So, you know.
I did a show last year, I think it was October, November, and that they had the dearest little mixed poodle, and I forget if her name was Sandy, but she was just perfection, just the dearest little thing, and they had to give it over to the South Hills Rescue past Library PA, but he does shows for me. And he brought her, she just sat right here like a little queen the whole time, you know. And for them to have to bring her down there and say, here, we can't feed her anymore. And they offered to help, and they said no, that they had to completely move out of their place where they were living, and they were going to put them here or whatever, and they couldn't have the dog anymore. And I know that she got a really wonderful home, but it's so sad.
It's very sad. Yeah,
a lot of people lose their homes, owners passing away. You know,
that's
family members
a good
can't
one.
Take them.
That's a good one.
And so it's where you got to kind of step in and help the community. Yeah.
I think a lot of the Chihuahuas, because you see a lot of Chihuahuas anymore in the shelters, which is like unbelievable.
We have two. They're a bonded pair. They were abandoned in a home.
Yeah, and I think that older ladies get those, you know, and they have them for 9 years or something, and they pass away, and there's no family. Nobody wants them.
Yeah.
So, you know, they put them in, and they get homes. A friend of ours just went down to Animal Friends and got a Chihuahua. She's like 9 or 10 years old. She doesn't have too many teeth left. Aww. And the lady is ill. She's older, and she's ill. And her husband went down and got her, because they always had a dog, and their dog passed away. So he went down and got her this dog and brought it home. Well, that was a sorry day for him, because, you know, Chihuahuas only like one person.
Yeah.
So he says all the time, she gives me the eye. You know?
They may be small, but they're mighty.
But she loves his wife, and she'll let him pet her and stuff, you know.
Yeah.
But the joy that she has brought them in their home, you know, and they're both 74, 80 years old. So, you know, they'll be together till the end, and that's a wonderful thing.
Oh, I think so.
I think a lot more people need to give dogs in shelters and rescues a chance. Mm-hmm. They might not be perfect from the very minute you take them in, but a little bit of time and patience.
Patience. And you don't always have to get a puppy.
No. Mm-hmm.
You know, you can go down and get an older one.
You might not have time for a puppy. You know, go through the housebreaking and the chewing. Mm-hmm. You know, an older dog is already broke like that. So
that's
you just
a good
need
point.
A little bit of time to get into your routine, and you have the most perfect dog in the world.
That's right.
That's a good point. Mm-hmm. That really is.
Just a little bit of time makes a big difference.
Yeah. Wow. So what time do you guys go to work in the morning, and what time do you get to work? On for the
depends on the day. Yeah. I think we're up 5:36 every morning and go from there.
We got a little bit of break with the warmer weather right now, so we're not as crazy.
Yeah, yeah.
But as soon as it dips down between under 32,
oh, that was
we'll be
madness.
Back out.
That was madness. Mm-hmm. I'd lay in bed at night and I would just pray and I would think, you know, about a kitty cat or you know a dog, and I think, oh please.
That's why we like we have a nice support in our police departments in our areas. Some of them will assist us at night.
Oh.
Yeah.
Which is really important, you know.
Yeah. Wow.
So, but, yeah.
Well, they take you guys seriously then, huh?
Yeah, and a lot of them are just as, you know, in some officers don't know that they can do the same thing that we do. They don't realize that it's in their crime code as well, and they can do all of this.
Now, did you have to go to school?
Yeah, we did training.
We did training.
Wow. Yeah. And where was this at?
Harrisburg was for half, and Penn State was the other half.
Yeah. Wow.
So you do have to do complete courses and pass testing. And
we go every year for
recertification.
Continuing education.
Wow. Now, of course, you paid for that yourself.
It depends. It really depends. We may have to fundraise for it. You know, some of us will pay out of our own pockets. We don't, you know, and some will fundraise. You know.
Yeah, there's we go to as many educational seminars to help as we can.
Yeah.
We're building great rapport with our vets in the area, our district attorneys.
Yeah.
It's resources.
See
you
all
know?
The things.
Yeah.
Working with the animal controls.
And guess what? It's time to go.
Wow.
I want to thank you both.
No, thank you.
Thank you
so much for coming. And I know it's going to be a good year because I had two wonderful young ladies. And we'll do shows in the summer.
Yes.
Okay, so we can get you out there.
Okay.
Like always, please remember your humane societies. They need sheets and towels. Food, money, but I like it if you give them sheets and towels and blankets and stuff, and spring will be coming, they'll be needing them for the mamas that'll be having babies, so it's really a wonderful thing to do, and I know these young ladies are on the job, and there's going to be lots and lots of animals saved, so the information will be at the end of the show. So that if you would like to send the money, you know I don't ask money very often. But this is going to be a very, very wonderful and rewarding thing that these young ladies are going to do. So, like always, I love you. And thanks from all the Tailwaggers.